Kentucky. This is Mary Jo Perino. Tonight, one economic expert says the state should have moved to reopen weeks ago. COVID-19 complications in kids worry Kentucky daycares. And Pro Football Focus loves Kentucky football. All that and more is next on Hey Kentucky. Welcome to Hey Kentucky with LEX 18 Sports Director Keith Farmer. Very few places in the world can it be 50 degrees and raining one day, and the next day, 80 degrees and sunny. It's perfect.
If you don't like the weather in Kentucky, just wait another hour, wait another day. It's going to change,
you know.
And yeah, amazing day today, though.
Yep, beautiful. All right. A UofL economist is criticizing the decision to gradually reopen the state of Kentucky during the pandemic. Dr. Paul Coombs says the economic damage done by the shutdown led by Governor Beshear is, quote, self-inflicted. The Louisville professor agrees that the initial response to COVID-19 was necessary. But he says that, given the relatively low number of cases in the state, leaders should have moved up the reopening schedule in the face of crushing unemployment. But a Louisville city health official counters Coombs' argument, saying the gradual reopening is the reason Kentucky has been able to keep its coronavirus numbers down. Keith, it's a real chicken and egg situation here. We've always seemed like we were lower than other places, but we also took perhaps more drastic measures initially. So maybe that's why the number was lower.
Yeah, a little bit hard for me to answer this one just because, you know, I've been able to keep my job throughout. So I err on the side of I think we played it safe, and I think that's a good thing, and we are starting to open up. At the same time, I'm not tone deaf to the fact that we've had a lot of problem with unemployment, and it's just, it would have been good to see us get back a little sooner in that aspect.
Yeah, we're sitting here in our ivory towers, blessed every day. All right, we are also learning how deeply the state might cut spending in anticipation of the overall impact of the virus. A letter to the heads of state agencies dated April 29th has been released, which asks them to cut spending by over 12% for the fiscal year that ends June 30th. State Republicans are criticizing the Beshear administration for a line in the letter, which instructs the recipients to keep communications in draft form and marked preliminary. This means the letter would not have to be made public under Kentucky's Open Records Act. But the state budget director who wrote the letter defends that line, saying the proposed cuts are not final yet. And Keith, I understand that none of these cuts are final yet because they could actually be deeper than what they were initially asking for.
Yeah, and it looks like we don't have to go through an open records because we have the letter right there and we can see it. But yeah, I didn't even know you could do that. I guess it makes sense if it's preliminary, but you're right. I mean, this may be the start of many cuts to come, and it's just getting us through this June date.
Yeah, it's not over today, so we don't know what is coming next. The prospect of reopening their doors next month is becoming worrisome for some Kentucky daycare owners in light of recent COVID-19 cases affecting younger victims. The state's daycare owners will be allowed to reopen their businesses beginning June 15th. But some say they don't plan on doing that during a time when the coronavirus is affecting kids. Others say they plan to forge ahead and provide childcare for families as they return to work. This week, we learned that a 10-year-old and a 16-year-old were being treated for a mysterious syndrome linked to COVID-19, which causes their immune systems to become overactive and creates an inflammatory response. The 10-year-old is improving, but was still on a ventilator at last word. And Keith, while this is still very rare, it affects about 1 in 1,000 children who test positive for COVID. If you're that one, gosh, it's life-threatening and terrifying.
You know, and again, it comes back to the employment thing again, you know, because if you're a parent that maybe been out of work and you're getting the chance to go back, you almost may not have a choice. I know when we've lived in a couple of places, we haven't had anybody really around that we knew, especially family members and things. And so, you know, you almost have to rely on those being open, those child daycares being open in order to get back to work. So it's again, you know, catch 22 on that.
Yeah, and that can also be an immense burden on your friends and family as well. You know, that's a 40-hour a week, more than that job to take care of kids. So the daycares fill an important role. The University of Kentucky has released 4 possible scenarios for the upcoming fall semester. They include plans for a normal start, a delayed start, a hybrid semester, and a fully online semester. All scenarios involve eliminating fall break and possible extension of instruction to evenings and even Saturdays. School President Dr. Eli Capiluto has invited feedback from the campus community with a deadline of tomorrow at 5. UK says a final plan will be shared for input later this month. And Keith, there are other things they're looking into, including like how to have a true freshman experience if everything is online, or reduced number of applicants and registrants for the fall semester.
I mean, not only that, imagine if it's your senior year coming up and just having to do maybe that first semester all online. I know my son, when they were doing that in the spring semester, some of them became pass-fail instead of graded. I mean, there's a lot of factors here. And I do like the fact that they're at least asking what the students would like. Maybe they'll go with it, maybe they won't, but at least they're giving some input and finding out what the students would like to do.
Yeah, they're getting input. All right, turning to UK football, many media outlets have not shown much love to the Cats when predicting the results of the upcoming season, but Pro Football Focus is giving the Cats credit for bringing back some really talented performers. We already know Stoops' recruiting class is highly regarded. Well, PFF singles out Darian Kennard and Landon Young on its list of highest graded returning SEC offensive tackles. Max Duffy's also on the list. PFF has a history of including Kentucky's team and even individual Wildcats in its discussions. Keith, the offensive line is going to be one of the best in the SEC, if not the nation. And there's other areas that are going to be really good, too.
Yeah, you're talking about defensive backs, which have been solid last year and brought almost everybody back. And then you also think about the wide receivers who really didn't get to showcase what they could do last year because they were doing more blocking than they were running pass routes. So they're excited about this year and getting one of those guys under center that's, you know, ready to throw the ball out there and keep defenses honest. But you're right about the offensive line. It's a good one.
Yeah, it is a good one. More on Landon Young later in the show, which is awesome. All right, now to our weekly feature on Hey Kentucky, What's the Beef? Sponsored by the Kentucky Beef Council. We've got two beefs tonight, beginning with an update on the Breonna Taylor shooting case in Louisville. The killing of the 26-year-old EMT during a police raid in March has drawn national attention, including calls for federal investigation from around the country. Meanwhile, Rand Paul has a beef with presidential candidate Joe Biden. Kentucky senator says the former vice president was caught red-handed eavesdropping on former Trump national security advisor Michael Flynn after it was revealed the National Security Agency received a request in Biden's name to unmask Flynn's identity in a classified transcript. And that's tonight's edition of What's the Beef? Up next on Hey Kentucky, we'll get another perspective on the state's efforts to reopen. My interview with Ashley Watts of Kentucky's Chamber of Commerce is coming up next.